Hi there everybody, my name's Jason de Wilde and I'm the head of audio here at the Australian Institute of Music, and welcome to another micro lecture. I had a request from somebody asking about how to do tempo mapping in Pro Tools. And tempo mapping is where, instead of working, where musicians are working to a click track, it's where musicians have recorded without a click track, and we are now moving Pro Tools to match the tempo that the musicians are playing. So here is a micro lecture on that. Enjoy. All right, so here we are. We're going to do some tempo mapping today on this particular Pro Tools session. And you'll note that along the tempo ruler here, it's just sitting at 120 beats per minute, but that actually isn't the tempo of the song. So let's have a quick listen to the track anyway, just quick listen. And you'll notice that the tempo doesn't go along with the beats of the song at all. Okay, so obviously when it's not 120 beats per minute, so I'm going to show you how to get this up and happening right now. So the drums have been played, and so what we're going to do is try and match the grid to what the drums are actually doing. So I'm going to actually solo the kick and the snare, because they're the ones that are probably going to just drive along the most. And I'm just going to increase the height of this a little bit so you can see a little easier. Okay, so the kick and the snare are really much driving the track and the track's tempo. So firstly, we need to be in slip mode. So the basic idea is we're going to position the cursor alongside the kick drum, and then we're going to just tell Pro Tools what beat that actually is. So here is the very first kick, okay? And I'm going to switch on the tab to transient button just here. So now when I do that, when I press the tab button, it'll move it directly to where the kick drum actually is. And if I zoom in, you can actually see that the cursor is now right on the kick drum. Okay, so if I was to play it from here, all right, that's bar one. So according to Pro Tools now, it's set at bar three, right? Because it's just going at 120 beats per minute. So I'm gonna actually say no, Pro Tools is not bar three, this is actually bar one. So the shortcut to do this is Command I, right? Which is called the Identify Beat command. And here it's saying, well, the location is bar three, but I'm just now just gonna turn it into bar one. All right, by just pressing the one, and now that actually makes it bar one, beat one, tick 000. Okay, so as soon as I do that, all right, and press OK, it thinks now, right, that it is, that Pro Tools is now actually at bar one, but it's still sitting at 120 beats per minute. We'll change that in a second. So so we've now identified where bar one actually is, right? So we just move along a little bit. 2, 3, 4. Right, so this kick drum here is actually where bar two is. So again, I'm going to now tab forward. All right, so here's the cursor on the kick drum, tab forward. That actually makes it to bar two. So that kick drum is where bar two actually starts. According to this, this is bar two, beat two. So that's not correct. So I'm going to choose Command I one more time. And now I'm going to make it bar two. All right, so now we click OK. All right, so you can see that we've identified bar one, and now we've identified bar two. So now there's a reference point in between. So it's actually saying that between this kick drum and this kick drum, the tempo is at 95.4116 beats per minute. Okay, now this track has actually been fairly consistently played. So I'm going to guess, and it's pretty much, you can see that the bar numbers are actually kind of matching to where these kick drums are. So I'm going to just now just continue on. So here, I'm going to assume that that's bar three, and I'm pretty sure that is. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1. All right, so that's going to be bar three. All right, and I'm going to Command I that again and say bar three. All right, then that one here is bar four, Command I. Right, and you can see that actually it comes fairly close, all right? It's bar four, This one here is going to be bar 5. So I'm just choosing Command I each time and just numbering the bars. And you can see that the drummer's just slightly changed tempo a little bit, but pretty good. 1, 2, 3, 4. So just here. Okay, now this is now starting to get very, very handy. So we can just continue and map all of the bars. This one's going to be bar 5. All right. This kick drum here, you can see it's pretty much the same pattern. This one's bar 6. Okay. We'll just do one more. No, that one looks there to be bar 7. Command I, bar 7. All right. So now it's pretty much keeping on time. Now, if the test is, of course, is we when we would do this all the way through the track, actually, but the test is, okay, that it kind of looks okay up on the main counter, which it does. And the other thing you can do to test it is to actually just create a click track. All right, just pop that up in here, and that should run in time with the music as well. Which is great. So now what it's done is we've now changed Pro Tools grid to match a played and performed part. And this is going to be very handy if we want to actually put MIDI tracks in, or if we want to rewire stuff. It's great for having tempo matched delay times and so on and so forth. So one other thing that I should have probably mentioned is that this will only work, right, if you go to the transport window, okay, this whole technique will only work if the conductor is switched on. If I was to switch the conductor off, you'll see that it goes into what's called a manual tempo mode, and that means pretty much that the tempo is fixed. You can change the value of it, but you change the value of it here, right? But it won't allow you to do tempo changes throughout the song. So the conductor allows you to switch and change tempos throughout the track. So that's a basic tempo mapping on Pro Tools. Very, very handy, and I hope you enjoyed that. So I hope you enjoyed that microlecture on tempo mapping in Pro Tools. If you've got any other suggestions for microlectures in terms of Pro Tools or Reason, please feel free to send us a request. And also, don't forget to subscribe to AIM TV Sydney. Till the next microlecture, see you soon.